don't know why, but when I think about Christmas, it makes me smile. Oh, I know it's got something to do with my childhood dreams of presents under the tree and snowy Christmas mornings and family gatherings. But on a much deeper level, I feel a sort of hope about the future. You know, I wonder if the people of God 2,000 years ago had any sense that something amazing was about to happen that night when Jesus was born.
Thank you. The entire Old Testament is filled with prophecies of a coming Messiah, one that would save the entire world. If you were to imagine a savior, it probably would be a king, a politician, or even a pastor. It probably wouldn't be a tiny baby. Babies are some of the most vulnerable among us. Every single one of their needs must be provided for by an adult who can care for them. A baby can't save another person, let alone an entire world. Infants are one of God's biggest blessings, and God chose to send Jesus into this world as a tiny baby boy. Jesus was fully man, but he was also fully God. And on that holy night in Bethlehem, a miracle happened. A baby boy was born to take away the sins of the world. And I can't imagine anything more miraculous than that.
Mercure. Gaspar.
A star shall come forth.
Please.
wow, what would I have done if I had been there? Well, so the Bible says there were these shepherds living out in the field nearby, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared to them. And the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were terrified. I suppose I'd be terrified too. And then it says, but the angel said to them, do not be afraid, for I bring you good news that will cause great joy to all people. For today in the city of David, a Savior has been born, the Messiah, the Lord. Now, this will be a sign to you. You will find the baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a food trough, a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. Yeah, that's hard for me to imagine. But man, I would love to have been there.
Isaiah 9:6 says, "For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace."
Come see the baby, cribbed for a bed. His mother Mary laid down his sweet head. The starlight was shining, the wise men were led. Come see. Everlasting Father, Emmanuel, Holy One, Son of God, the Savior.
Christmas isn't a happy time for everyone. Illness and tragedy and even death take no holiday. Both my parents died sudden, unexpected deaths in December, right before Christmas. On two different Christmas mornings, I opened presents from my parents had wrapped for me, purchased for me, but did not live to see me open them. We have people in our church family this year who are spending their first Christmas without a parent or a spouse or even a child. What do we say to those people? Well, we say it's tough to go through the celebration of Christmas without a loved one, but it would be even tougher to go through life without the celebration of Christmas. Thank God for Christmas, even if it brings us pain, because Christmas also brings us the hope of eternal life in heaven where there'll be no separation or pain. When your circumstances are not ideal at Christmas, it allows you to focus on its real meaning. When holiday trappings are stripped away, it allows you to focus on Jesus, to behold Him, and you'll find Him to be enough, more than enough.
She put up the tree, stockings 1, 2, 3, they all know one is missing. It's been a whole year without Him right here. Won't be the same kind of Christmas. Some years just wander in lights in the sky. Some years it's okay to cry.
You know, the word Noel has a really rich meaning and history to it. Before the English were using the word, the French meaning of the word, there were a couple of different variations, but the French meaning of the word was good news or even Christmas. But before the French were using it, the Latin variations of the word meant to be born or birthday. So Noel means that we're celebrating the good news of the birth of Jesus. So why do we sing at Christmas? We sing because we have a Savior. We sing because of the birth of Jesus. We sing because He gave us eternal life.
Thank you. favorite Christmas memories. So probably when I was about 6 years old, my brother and I shared a bedroom at that phase in our lives. And we both woke up probably, I don't know, maybe 3 a.m. And we ran to the living room to go look at all the toys that Santa had brought us. And we found this like opened G.I. Joe fort with all these figures. And we stayed up the whole night playing with that G.I. Joe set. And then we crashed on the living room couch and didn't wake up until about 10 a.m. Now, in our house, one of my favorite things is when we get trees up and all the decorations. It doesn't matter what we pull out of the little Rubbermaid tubs. Elliot and Caitlin will both go, "Wow!" And it's just a really cute kind of thing that I'll probably always hold on to. I even say it now when I pull out things and ornaments or whatever. I say, "Hey, Katie, look at this. Wow," you know, anyway. So, all right, so the sounds that make me think of Christmas. Right now, it's a lot about Katie singing in the house and hearing her sing Christmas carols. You know, I think also it's always the sound of joy that your kids and family make together as we're celebrating Christmas. Because it just goes back to the timeless truth that God loved us enough to leave heaven, come to earth, to save people who would be absolutely lost without him.
It's the sound of falling snow as we hurry out to go caroling with family and with friends. It's the laughter in the air by the fireside we share, sweet memories we've made throughout the years. And as we gather close with those we love the most, we read the story of Jesus. Christmas time is here. Can you hear it? The sound of peace on earth. It's the song of Christmas. Celebrate his birth. It's the chorus that rings in human hearts. God came down here with us. It's the song of Christmas. And Mary softly spoke his name as the angel chorus sang, announcing that our Savior had been born. And Joseph prayed to God above for this precious gift of love as he held the hope of heaven in his arms. The shepherds spread the word, the greatest story ever heard, how God came down to save us, our Lord Emmanuel. Can you hear it? The sound of peace on earth. It's the song of Christmas. Celebrate his birth. It's the chorus that rings in human hearts. Song of Christmas. The message is so clear. It's the same year after year. The sound of hope. And you hear
it's the song of Christmas.
So why did Jesus come in such a humble way? You know, Jesus is the perfect example of humility. Even from his beginning, from his birth, being born in a stable, lying in a manger, to throughout his life where Jesus came to serve others, not to be served. All the way through his death, where Jesus died on the cross, being obedient to his Father. In our place, he took on our sin and died a death that we deserved. You know, the book of Philippians describes this humility of his life, from his birth to his life, all the way through his death, leading to his exaltation. Listen to what Philippians 2 says. Therefore, God has highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name that is above every name, so that the name of Jesus every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God our Father. Jesus was a perfect example of humility.
Why should Christians rejoice at Christmas? Well, the first thing is that Christians are commanded to always rejoice. And again, I say it, rejoice. This is a command. But not only that, you know, Christmas is the Super Bowl of rejoicing for us. And that's because our greatest problem has been solved. This baby in the manger has become the solution for our greatest problem, which means our great hope, it's come true. All that we have hoped for is now true in Jesus, which means God provided the greatest gift that we could ever ask for, which means we have a God who loves us, wants to know us, and has made it possible that we can know and enjoy Him forever, which finally means that even if Christmas isn't how you would hope it to be right now. Maybe there's family members who aren't going to be there this year, or life is not how you thought it would be, or your circumstances are not how you were hoping they would have worked out. Jesus has made it possible. He has made a way that right now this life is better than you had hoped for, and your life for all eternity is better than you could ever dream of. And that's why we rejoice at Christmas, because of what this baby in the manger has done for us.
Jesus.
not celebrate Christmas were it not for what came after Christmas. The baby, Jesus, who was born at Christmas, grew up to be a man. He healed the sick. He cast out demons. He taught us about the Father. And then he was put to death to pay the price for our sins. He rose from the dead to break the power of death. That is why he was born. The writer of Hebrews put it this way. Since the children, that's you and I, have flesh and blood, Jesus too shared in our humanity so that by his death he might break the power of him who holds the power of death, the devil, and free those who all their lives were held in slavery by their fear of death. The fear of death has been broken. And now Jesus is alive and well. He's enthroned in heaven. His Spirit lives in the chests of those who follow Him. And His name and His kingdom are being proclaimed around the world. And one day, He'll return to earth to complete His mission and reign forever. Several years after He died, rose from the dead, and ascended to heaven, He appeared to His disciple John in a vision on the island of Patmos. And Jesus said this, "Do not be afraid. I'm the first and the last. I'm the living one. I was dead, and now look, I'm alive forever and ever." Praise the name of Jesus.
Rejected with nails in his hands and through his